Hi guys, it is the first long weekend since the COVID restrictions have been lifted in Western Australia, and just like everyone else from Perth, I've headed down with my family to Margaret River for a bit of a holiday. Being new to YouTube, I actually have forgotten to produce any content for this week, but I thought I'd take the opportunity to talk a little bit about my background and what got me into property, my professional career, my personal investing journey, and also why I have started this YouTube channel. I actually started in real estate over a decade ago, and leaving the industry and coming back, it was quite interesting because the inspiration for starting this particular channel and going through this content is that there has become a lot more people providing advice, offering buyer's agency services. And I thought to myself, really, a lot of these are actually overcomplicating in order to sell a service and sell guidance and advice. There's actually nothing complicated about property investing. The fundamentals are the same. They're 100% the same. People just make it more complicated so they can sell you shit. And I don't want to be the one going out there and flogging stuff to people that don't actually need it. I'd much rather be doing the stuff that I enjoy and working with clients that I want to work with that can get some value out of what I want to do. In fact, you can probably get 80% of the returns you would in property investing by doing 20% of the effort yourself. My first brush with property investing was early on because my parents believed in financially educating me from a young age. I actually went into a lot of property seminars with my dad because he was a property investor, not super wealthy by any stretch of the imagination, but he had two investment properties. It was interesting because those two investment properties kind of shed light on two different strategies. The first being it was a unit. It was in a good school area. It was an older unit that he bought and renovated. Then he bought the second investment property, and that was effectively a recommendation from a property promoter, and they suggested a house and land package out in the middle of nowhere. Now he held them for 5, 10, 15 years, I don't know, but I'll put the numbers up on the screen. And he sold both of them. And ultimately, when he backwards calculated the numbers once he sold those properties, the house and land package was simply just a forced savings plan where the unit that he did actually generated pretty good investment returns. Now, he didn't know a huge amount about property investing, but he did it and he got a good result. And that's what got me interested in the property industry. So fast forward to when I was 16, I got a job before I started university in a selling agency, which I gave up to study my Bachelor of Economics at UWA. And I was always interested in wealth creation and personal finance. And after university, I got a job with Perth's largest independent buy-side property advisory firm. It grew to about 70 staff while I was there. And I started in a research and education role, but I was quite quickly promoted into buyer's agency. Working as a buyer's agent, I was fortunate to be recognized by my peers, and I won the REWA 2014, 2015, 2016 Awards for Excellence under buyer's agency. I went on to represent Western Australia nationally in those awards, and I did win in those categories again. Ultimately, this led me to being inducted into the Real Estate Hall of Fame. I continued with this firm for a couple of years, but ultimately I left there in a property development and syndication capacity, working on a $30 million apartment development was the last project that I was involved in. The move from there was into family offices, and the reason why I made that particular move was because I wanted to understand what people with money did when they invested in property. I worked in the family office space for a couple of years, working for two different family offices, and my primary focus was around residential property development and value adding on commercial property. This gets me onto the current day where I founded Realigned, which is my own property development, property investment, and buyer's agency advisory business. I wanted to found Realigned for a long time, but the Perth real estate market's been quite difficult, and I wanted to have credibility and conviction in my view that now was the right time to be looking at property, real estate development in Perth, Western Australia. The Realigned business for me is a passion project, kind of like why I started this YouTube channel. I left the industry a couple of years ago, came back, and it's changed a bit. There's really two types of property advisors out there. There's the incumbents, and they offer the traditional service, But they haven't changed with the times. Technology is moving forward with anything, and you can often save a lot of cost with technology. So I thought, well, let's combine my passion with technology, apply it to real estate, and let's see if we can simplify it. The second thing that's happened is that there's a lot more of upstarts. There's a lot more people out there trying to provide some service or advice, but really, they don't have a track record. They don't have experience. I don't want to say they don't know what they're doing, but really, if you haven't made your own wealth through property and become financially independent, or given advice to a hell of a lot of people over a decade, I hardly see where your qualifications come to be able to go out and give advice to people around one of the biggest, if not their biggest, transactions that they'll make in their life, which is a property investment. But this is enough about Realigned. I want to get onto my own personal financial journey. My first investment in real estate was effectively 2 years after I started working full time. I purchased a house in Brookdale. It was a 5-bedroom, 2-bathroom home, 700 square meter block. I renovated that property over 9 months and I sold it on for a profit. I made about $40,000. The next property I purchased was in Kelmscott. It actually took me 11 months to find that property. Over 12 months, I bought it, I renovated the house, I split the block in two, I sold the block as a house and land package, I sold the house fully renovated, and I think that project netted me over about $120,000, $130,000. So for the next couple of years, I continued to save and invest in property deals. I also diversified into stocks, but I have to say, there is no real shortcut on a lot of this stuff. Ultimately, it really comes down to spending less than you earn and saving and reinvesting that money. I could have taken that money that I got from my deals and I could have plowed it into purchasing a car. So now that I've built up a bit of a nest egg, let's go to about 3 years ago. I wanted to move away from looking at purchasing growth assets into purchasing cash flow assets, because ultimately financial independence is about generating an income. The traditional type is passive income stream. So this is things like stocks, which get dividends, or commercial real estate that pays higher rents or higher yields. The other opportunity which you can look into, which is where I went, was businesses with reoccurring income. And that's the key there, is reoccurring income. The other thing with using businesses for financial independence is you need to focus on one where other people can be working in the business doing the day-to-day operations so that you can effectively step away and do things like create these YouTube videos. So I purchased two property management businesses. I must stress that I didn't make money out of the businesses. I built up a nest egg through investing to purchase the businesses. I also didn't use all my money in buying the businesses. I've got a share portfolio, I've got other property investments, and I'm not gonna go and say granularly what my net worth is, but those real estate businesses alone today would be worth about $2 million. That gives you the idea of my own personal financial journey. So getting onto the YouTube channel, why did I start it? Well, similar to Realigned, I come back into the property industry to see that buyer's agency is a lot more competitive. And with that, a lot of buyer's agents now are throwing in all of these new things like cash flow strategies with granny flats and development with rezoning and buying in regional towns and buying in interstate and doing all these different things. Fundamentally, all it is more complexity, and that more complexity is so that they can provide a service, provide advice. The fundamentals on property investment hasn't changed. In fact, you can probably get 80% of the returns you would in property investing by doing 20% of the effort yourself. And you're not gonna have to be copying all those fees. My clients are either time poor, they're a doctor, lawyer, accountant, they work 40, 50, 60 hours a week, and they just don't have that time to do the right research. Or they could be, you know, engineers that understand it, but then all of the things that are conflicting has given them kind of a analysis paralysis, and they don't know which path that they need to take. So they're happy to pay someone to send them down the right path that's done it with a track record. Or, you know, they may just feel like they don't want to get ripped off or led down the garden path, and they're happy to pay someone who is genuine in the advice they give and they're mainly my clients. They're not people that want to do it themselves. What I wanted to do with this YouTube channel is be radically transparent with the knowledge I give. Everything that I've learned working as a buyer's agent, working in the property fund space, working in the family office space, property development, value add commercial property, I want to share with that because there's no one out there actually giving that information away for free. And if you want that and do it yourself, that's fine. You're never going to be my client anyway. The biggest thing that you guys can do is share with me where your knowledge gaps are so that I can produce the content that fills it. Because if you have that question, it's more than likely other people have that question. Each week, what I want to do is commit to posting two videos. The first video will be always around the property space. The second video is more about personal wealth, personal finance, because what I found when building my own portfolio is that it's not just all about property to build wealth. Savings is a massive component. What I did with savings, how did I do that? Investing in shares and diversification, what I did there, there's a whole raft of things. So ultimately, this is going to be a soundboard around anything that relates to personal finance. In terms of the content on this YouTube channel, I'm never going to charge for it in terms of the expensive courses you see in the real estate industry. And I can assure you the content that I'll produce will be to the same level, if not better, than half the courses that are out there. So with that, what I would like you to do is hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, and more people can gain that knowledge just like you have now by watching my videos. And we have arrived.